1973 National Scout Jamboree. 44,000 scouts from the 50 states and 20 foreign countries. The breathtaking, king-sized, all-stops-out scout happening. Here on the shores of Lake Arthur at Moraine State Park, 40 miles north of Pittsburgh. Arriving in all types of vehicles, Cadillacs to Toyotas, school buses to streamlined Greyhounds. One troop hiked from Philadelphia. One man ran from New Hampshire. One patrol cycled all the way from Michigan. We came in two school buses, 41 scouts and scouters from Troop 61, joining the encampment, ready for a week of fun, excitement, and making new friends. How did we get here? What was involved in preparing this super adventure? Let's go back in time for a look at some of the preparations that began almost a year earlier. £369,000 of paper. That's the amount collected in the monthly paper drives from September 1972 to June 1973. Money earned was used to finance the trip for scouts and to pay for their total individual fee of $60. That's quite a low amount, considering most scouts attending the Jamboree paid fees of several hundred dollars. Thank you. Living together as patrols started at the Jamboree training camp at Camp Journal. Here, the Jamboree patrols were formed and began to function as they would at the Jamboree, cooking, eating, participating in sporting events and contests, playing an improvised football game complete with the roll call of players, and planning campfire skits. Planning ended in the final packing for the long-awaited trip. Checking each tent, making charcoal fire starters, packing each bit of camping and program equipment in the right box. This involved not only those attending the Jamboree, but also the other members of the troop who could not attend. Northwest Orient Flight 495 from New York, arriving at Gate 9. Deplaning passenger Tom Bledsoe, please meet your hosts, the Rowans, at the baggage counter. Getting up at 3 a.m. to catch the Jamboree buses was hard enough, but Tom Bledsoe flew all the way from his home in New York back to Milwaukee to be with us. Tom's trip to the Jamboree thus involved a New York commuter train, a plane, and the school buses. Wonder which one was most comfortable. After Father Joe's blessing and Lee Finna's coffee, we were on the road to adventure. The miles passed quickly, listening to WAVN Radio's special taped broadcasts, playing games, watching the scenery speed by, and sleeping. Piloted by experienced drivers, navigated by true scout pathfinders, we traveled for 2 days with an overnight stop on the shores of Lake Erie. The only thing missing was a timekeeper to keep track of the true and make-believe time zones that we traveled through. We swam in Lake Erie, played volleyball, and, of course, ate. With all the preparations and travel behind us, we're back at the Jamboree. Let's look at all the events of that week. At the Jamboree was to set up our homes for the week, the tents, picnic tables, and dining tarps. With good efficiency, the camp quickly took shape. Most of the troops set up the campsite. The buses were parked at the parking lot, a 20-mile trip, requiring a boat trip to get back. The show was held in a large outdoor amphitheater with Lake Arthur in the background, looking rather quiet when empty. It was a sea of red as the red berets and red jackets of the scouts quickly filled in. One word describes the show: big. An audience of 44,000 scouts and 20,000 visitors. A 200-foot replica of the American flag. Huge viewing screens for movies and TVs. A fireworks display many times more spectacular than the Schlitz display, and Danny Thomas speaking of his faith in American youth. This was getting everyone together. Tomorrow, the scouts would begin to meet many of their peers in this crowd, as they would be then more than just faces. They would meet while trading patches, waiting in line for a soda, and participating in the many activities and events. Tim Rowan met scouts from 47 different states and 11 different foreign countries. Louis French met a cousin from Washington. Bobby Cole, a friend from Oklahoma. We'll be right back. wide game, and wide it was. Give a color-coded card with a letter of the alphabet to each of 44,000 scouts scattered over several miles. Ask them to get together and spell out the words, growing together. And you have the world's largest game of Scrabble, or maybe Scramble. Linked arm to arm, scouts would call out here for a green T, there for a brown E, grabbing quickly scouts with the letters needed to complete the phrase, going together. For forming the 14 new friendships, scouts earned a segment to place with their jamboree patch. Trading patches was a great way to meet new friends and to get colorful souvenirs of faraway places and events.
Cause we are making the world better, growing together each day.
The Skill-O-Rama, scouts demonstrated and participated in a wide spectrum of activities. Pioneering towers, monkey bridges, water polo, anything you could name. Some famous people visited us. But the most popular man in the show was none other than Harry Debris from Troop 61.
Ladies and gentlemen, step right up and see Harry Debris, the only living trained litterbug in captivity.
Glug, 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 glug.
No, friends, he doesn't eat people, but he likes to cook up the countryside.
Ho, ho, ho.
Cool it, Harry. You're not the Jolly Green Giant yet.
Oh.
Please, lady, don't feed him peanuts. He's been raised on litter, okay? Thank you, please.
Glared, glared.
Now, Harry, sing your litterbug song. Go ahead, sing it. You know how it is. That's fine.
Litterbug, shame on you. Look at the terrible things you do. Litterbug fluttering every place. My, but it's disgraceful. Litterbug, where's your pride? Making a mess of the countryside. Spoiling and soiling each love review. Shame, oh shame on you. It really makes one wonder what kind of house you keep. On every tour, the world is your personal garbage heap. Litterbug, don't you care? People must follow you everywhere. Cleaning up places that you've gone to. Litterbug, shame on you. Litterbug, shame on you. Look at the terrible things you do. Litterbug cluttering every place. My, but it's disgraceful. Litterbug, where's your pride? Making a mess of the countryside. Spoiling and soiling each love review. Shame, oh shame on you. It really makes one wonder what kind of house you keep. On every tour, the world is your personal garbage heap. Litterbug, don't you care? People must follow you everywhere. Cleaning up places that you've gone to. Litterbug, shame on you.
The Skill-O-Rama was also sampling the cooking skills of other scouts. Fried chicken, roast chicken, barbecued chicken, baked chicken, and chicken gumbo. Even Peking duck with chopsticks. Willie Stargell from the Pirates was here, also Miss Honeybee, and of course Pedro from Boys Life magazine. Part of Camp 19, Camp Shenango. But perhaps the only time many scouts were actually in camp was at meal times. There was no shortage of good food, but due to circumstances beyond our control, we had to cook it ourselves. You see, there was a rather serious shortage of mothers here. We polished off 160,000 hamburgers, 23,000 pounds of ribeye steak, 500,000 quarts of milk, 55,000 pounds of chicken, 44,000 fresh rainbow trout, 369,000 boxes of cereal, and 288,000 eggs. And in between meals, soda, 500,000 cans. And just think, this was only our troop. Paul Little, in the Navy in Virginia, joined us for 2 days. Eleven different church services were held for scouts of all faiths. Cardinal Cook of New York joined five bishops and scores of priests in concelebrating Mass for 15,000 Catholic scouts. The cross of his vestment was formed by jamboree patches. The game at this jamboree was action, and there was lots of it. 600 boats formed the jamboree fleet. Events included individual competitive events, the octathon, fishing, archery, and riflery. Hiking trails displayed the skills of nature and the outdoors. An Indian village with birch bark canoe and pioneer trapper's village were part of one trail. Of course, a Coke went well at trail's end. Midway displayed the work of top experts in merit badge field. 1,200 scouts showed their talents and experiences in the Arts and Science Expo. Both Louis French and Lee Pavlock had interesting exhibits. around and through the three-quarter-mile obstacle course. The patrols must cross a rope bridge, go up and over a horizontal rope climb, cross a log bridge, swing across a ravine on a rope, wiggle through a tree tunnel, up and over the reverse ladder, onto the high hoist station, and end up on the log rolling and raising field. To take care of that dirt and grime accumulated from the events such as the obstacle course, we had several modern conveniences. The shower houses were always crowded, the water a little too cold, and the sun a little too hot. Late model washing machines were frequently used by us. Let's listen to one cheerful washerman.
Washing clothes at the jamboree wasn't too bad. Blues are just blue, and the greens are green, but the whites weren't white because they took away my Clorox.
Thank you.
We had several visitors during the week, the most popular, a scout and leader from the Republic of China, Wong and Mr. Wu, who joined us for a dinner of knockwurst and sauerkraut. But worse than this, some of Mr. Renk's coffee. The universal language of friendship overcame the language barrier. Later, several scouts attended the China troops' tea party and campfire and participated in their campfire songs and events. In this same spirit, Troop 61 scouts donated a portion of their spending money to the World Friendship Fund for scouts in other lands. Louisiana troop from the bayous joined us for one campfire. Their Little Nemo skit kept everyone laughing. We shared the bedtime snack. And of course, the big highlight was again Mr. Renk's coffee, strong enough even to backfire. Had its own campfire to display the talents of its scouts. Again, the red jackets and berets filled the small arena, mixed with the green Canadian berets and yellow jackets. The Canadians entertained with some French Canadian songs. Scouts performed Indian dances. Rick Zebrowski played in the combo, and a group of scouts displayed pet snakes they brought to the jamboree. Thank you. The Jamboree was a vast city of tents, every color and shape dotting the hills and hollows. Distinctive gateways graced each troop's entranceway. Supporting this city were a 100-bed Army field hospital, a heliport, and a post office, bank, radio station, fire department, and telephone system. Army reservists had prepared much of the camp for a year prior to the Jamboree. The trading post was a gathering place to buy snacks and souvenirs and to trade anything to anybody. Morning paper listed all the happenings of the day. The only problem was to find enough time and walking strength to get to everything. Parachutists, sky riding, and balloons dotted the skies. And more down to earth was the conservation trail. Celebrities visited us, including Colonel Sanders.
Such a feeling's coming over me. There is wonder in most everything I see. Not a cloud in the sky, got the sun in my eyes, and I won't be surprised if it's a dream. Everything I want the world to be is now coming true, especially for I can find is the love that I've found ever since you've been around. Your love's put me at the top of the world.
closing arena show. Again, the gathering of the entire Jamboree. The Marine Corps Band entertained us. Awards were presented to the winners of various Jamboree events. The Secretary of the Navy and Ernie Banks were among the speakers. A lot of the faces in the crowd were now familiar. Each scout was given a candle, the light from which illuminated these faces, brightly brightening the entire arena with flickering flame, symbolic of the spirit binding together these scouts from all over the world. The Jamboree itself had ended. Suitcases and packs were crammed shut, enclosing precious souvenirs. Sleeping bags were rolled up and tents were coming down. The buses were packed and soon were rolling out of the park. But the adventure was not yet over. We had 3 days of travel before arriving back in Milwaukee. We camped overnight in Ohio and Indiana. Besides the adventures of the bus riding, we swam and swung from the ropes on trees over the water and visited a nuclear power plant in Michigan. The trip home was somewhat quieter, what with everyone catching up on their sleep. Thank you. But it was great to be back home, especially to the wonderful welcome arranged for us by the parents. Unpacking and cleaning the buses was quickly accomplished. Before we bring the story of the Jamboree to a finish with the actual sights and sounds of the fantastic fireworks display, aerial bombs, and finally the huge Jamboree emblem ground display, let's look a little closer at the scouts and the scouters who were at the Jamboree, what they accomplished, and some of their thoughts about the Jamboree. The real story of this Jamboree has 44,000 chapters about the scouts who lived and worked together behind the gateways. We were but 41, but 41 chapters can form a book. A book about meeting others. Four of our troop met scouts from more than 30 different states. A book about the scouting brotherhood that ensures success for this huge happening. A book about how planning and preparation can ensure the success of a super adventure. Behind those distinctive patrol banners are groups of some pretty sharp-looking scouts who can be proud of their accomplishments. Let's ask each of them for some of their thoughts about the Jamboree and then listen to the fireworks.
Well, it was great. When we hit the fireworks, it was spectacular. It was really great. Obstacle. It was a lot of fun. Even though I didn't make the first obstacle, it took me four times.
There's no one word that I said didn't get all fun to describe the Jamboree. It's just the fun of meeting all those people and doing all those things at the same time.
The people that you met were like Danny Thomas and some of the famous baseball players were really great, and they talked a lot, and they really understood what a boy's life meant.
You got to see all the different scouts and the different troops from all over the world. It was great.
You didn't have enough time to see everything. If it was about a week longer, everybody would have lots of fun because they get to see everything.
Fire was great.
Meeting different kinds of persons and knowing what their customs are and that.
How we all got together and was able to do just one main thing, which was to make friendship and have fun.
Neat. Favorite thing was the arena show.
Going together was the perfect team, and it worked fantastic with our troops.
It was exciting and we learned a lot.
And that obstacle course is good.
It is great. Terrific.
Well, everything was fun.
This crowd all around the boat, swimming, canoes, showers, all over.
Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
Wunderbar.
Unity.
Learn different techniques of doing things and camping.
Fun.
Good.
They didn't give us time to not like anything.
Well, it's only one word.
Well, it was fun and exciting.
interesting.
There was a lot of big booms, and there was a lot of big fireworks.
Great. I really enjoyed the live game. In the group I was in, there was a boy from Mexico and others from all over the country.
The hardest thing was probably the tires, which I didn't get through.
Very good adventure, one I'll always remember.
It was really fun, though. I think it was one of the best things I ever went to.
I like going over the obstacle course, swinging from that vine over a mud hole.
The food was great.
Fine. The showers were bad. They were cold. The obstacle course was all right. That, my casket just about fell in.
The obstacle course is probably one of the most fun things at the Jamboree. I really enjoyed it. And the food there was excellent. The showers were cold.
The best thing about the Jamboree is that Tom Butts was there, and it was fun with him. And, well, it was just great. There's much more to say about it, but...
Come up early morning light, breaking through the trees. Oh, what a sight, smelling something cooking. This could be a good day. Hearing some happy birds sing his heart out, being with my friends, that's what it's all about. Talking things over as we travel our way. Over the world, looking after our brother, being on hand when we're needing each other, knowing together tomorrow will be our best day ever, 'cause we're making the world better, growing together each day. We are growing together. watching over the world, looking after our brother, being on hand when we're needing each other.
Has been a BHNR production.